one of the things that I like to do at Build every year, and like I'll do a little bit more of this tomorrow, is to like try to make some predictions about the 12 months ahead. And you know, I think the thing that we can all see is like making those predictions even 12 months in advance, which you know, isn't a huge time horizon by normal standards, are incredibly difficult to do. So one of the big things that happened over the past 12 months that I think caught a whole bunch of people by surprise is the advent of these reasoning models and all of the things that reasoning inside of these advanced AI models unlock. So we have things like Copilot Researcher, things like deep research in ChatGPT that can do just incredible, extraordinary things. One of my core beliefs around AI right now, which is that we have this thing that I've been calling the capability overhang, where I think for a whole bunch of use cases, we're no longer necessarily reasoning constrained in the AI applications that we built. And in fact, there are just a ton of opportunities to have a higher ambition for the reasoning component of the agentic software that we're building. Rather than going off and doing a ton of research myself, like I would have done when I was a grad student, I just asked deep research how to solve the problem. And I asked it very specifically, like how it would solve the problem. And I asked it to write the code for it. And it asked one round of clarifying questions and then sent a complete solution back with 27 citations, including a bunch of medical literature where this problem had already been solved and a working bunch of Python code. And the share button in the app let me send it to my daughter. When I was in my 20s in grad school, having studied computer science for like a whole bunch of years, including, you know, taking an image processing course at some point, like that would have been a couple of days worth of solid work for me. And like this AI system had solved it in 4 minutes. One of the big themes of the Build conference is going to be around this idea of the agentic web. We likely aren't nearly as reasoning constrained as we have been in the past, but like there's a bunch of stuff in this ecosystem that has to get built out so that agents can more fully deliver what it is we hope that they can deliver. And like that, what that is you want agents to be able to delegate work to. And you want the work that you're delegating to these agents to be increasingly complicated over time. So, you know, we sort of think about this runtime layer that sits below agents, and like there's some really important pieces in this runtime that need real work. Some of these problems are going to get solved out in the open, like in the open source community, because like the important thing about them isn't that Microsoft's opinion gets expressed or some big tech company's opinion gets expressed, or like we've, you know, won some kind of technical argument. And so structured RAG is one of those biologically inspired techniques where we are imposing structure on top of context to help have more precise recollections for models so that memory can get better and so that you can reason over larger volumes of information. And so the important thing about the openness of these protocols and simplicity and trying to get to ubiquity as quickly as possible is that it means that like your imagination gets to drive what the agentic web becomes, like not just a handful of companies that, you know, happen to like see some of these problems first. You got a ton of space for innovation. And like we're seeing it, you know, many of you here in the room today who are like entrepreneurs and building new companies, like, man, I'm just seeing some extraordinary stuff happening at extraordinary speeds. The last time that I was as excited about being a software developer or a technologist as I am now was in the 90s. And one of the reasons why is I had this kid in a candy store set of building blocks, and I could just go play. And I could play because all of that stuff was permissionless. And so that's the moment you all are in right now. Like all of these building blocks are available to you. And like that's our challenge to all of you at Build. Like we're gonna give you a ton of tools to go work with, and then we hope you go do something cool with it.